I'm very glad that we have the opportunity to present this today. We have developed two R packages. The Wurzeln bus are a boxcar for the collection, calibration, and modeling of C14 dates. First of all, C14 dates are important.
C14 dating
is definitely revolutionized the way we do chronology in archaeology. Thanks to magic things like Bayesian statistics, Monte Carlo simulation, or seriation-based models, the accuracy of these kind of calibration, this kind of dating, reached now the level of generations or even beyond that. And supporting data is basically the gold standard for dating in archaeology as of today. Almost no archaeologist can work meaningfully without supporting data today. What can we add to this? How can we make this more accessible in R? The two packages we developed, first of all, C14 Bazaar and Oxcar, provide a way to download C14 dates from publicly accessible source databases and to use the power of the Oxcar tool from an R interface to provide good simulation and sequencing. First of all, about C14 Bazaar. Well, there are a lot of publicly available source databases. People who collected C14 dates in archives, who are freely available, they share it. But unfortunately, they are very heterogeneous, and they only share some common variables. It's very difficult to access them all to see where you can find dates for your purpose. C14 Bazaar offers a pretty simple workflow to get these dates. I had this in mind as something like get dates, apply some simple calibration steps, and then have a nice data set that you can use for your research. That's what we wanted to realize, and I think we reached that. From a user perspective, you get a pretty simple interface to access C14 dates. You work in a scripted environment, it's reproducible. And you can use the powerful tools of R, the tidyverse, for example, to work with this data. From a developer's perspective, it's an open source tool. You can examine the code. You can tweak it to your needs. And you can also enlarge it. You can write further parser functions. It's pretty simple to fit them into the system and make them also accessible. Also, you can embed C14 dates in your own web application or whatever you plan, as we did for our C14 date search engine, Neolithic RC. So let's do this. Let's apply this. We call data with, from Dirk's data set, ARTRAC, C14 data from Africa. We download it and we get something, a list of C14 dates, and the structure of an S3 class C14 date list. What is the C14 date list? Well, it's a three class modified tittle or data frame with a set of predefined variables. And these variables are basically the essence of this source database. It's more or less what all of them have. And the C14 dates date list also provides own class methods. And that's where basically the features coming term that I already mentioned. The first feature is bulk calibration. I mean, Martin's tool provides much better calibration options, but for first filtering, this is powerful because it's fast. It allows you to apply calibration to all those states. Unfortunately, you have to deal with list columns here because the result of calibration is always a little bit complicated. The second feature is material classification. In all the 80,000 dates we can query so far, we have about 1,000 different material categories. So we create manually created material thesaurus to reduce this to a much more manageable set of material types to make this more accessible and better searchable. The third feature is correcting the country information. That should be easy with longitude and latitude. We do this. But unfortunately, many dates don't come with this information. Some databases don't even have it. So we also apply another thing, standardization of country name by string comparison to country name code lists. Last feature, if you combine all those databases, we get a lot of duplicates. And already some databases, like for example Calpal, contain a lot of the duplicates inside of them. So 62% of the complete data sets are dates which appear more than once. Marking them is pretty easy because they have the lab code, so one standardized unified identifier. But removing them is quite difficult because some of them, some of the values or meta information in the databases are not equal. We have to lock kind of what we remove. So this is basically the workflow. You can get all dates. You can apply calibration, some of those steps, and you get a nice data set. In the end, this is code, you can run it, it works. Martin, what can you do with it?
Yes, if you have already downloaded with the C14 Bazaar a lot of dates, you want to probably do some fancy stuff with that. I mean, there's the basic calibration already embedded in the C14 Bazaar that relies on Bcron, but this might not be the end of the spectrum. So how can you calibrate currently C14 dates? And outside of R, there are several options for that, but I think OxCal is currently still the most standard way to do that in the archaeological research. There's also a small script calibrator that I've written myself. It's a C command line tool. Might be very useful in some situations, but not for elaborate stuff. And then you have probably Chrono model, which might be a rising star in this respect, but we have to wait if it is able to establish itself very prominently, like OxCal currently is. But within R, we have currently three options, and long time around is already Bcron, which works quite well. You can see here the code with which you can calibrate a C14 date with that tool. And there are two new kits on the block. One is from Andrew Beaven, that's R-Carbon, which do basic calibration also very well, relying on the same algorithm like OxCal is using. And we actually took a much more direct approach. We utilized OxCal itself to do the calibration for us, which has some benefits. One thing is, every package, at least in the R world, produces slightly different results. So if you compare here, and I hope it's partly visible, the calibration of one date, you can see already there are, if we look at that scale, some little differences here. If we zoom in and take the OxCal result as baseline, you can see that Bcron has some really remarkable differences in the calibration result, while R-Carbon, although it's kind of the same algorithm, still has some difference to that. And my background is actually applying calibration to bulk data, and there where the C14 Bazaar comes in very handy, to try to use them as a proxy for past intensities, or past activity intensities. And this already is a debatable method as such, and I wanted to use a most standard way of calibrating to reduce any doubt about this part of my methodology. So that's why I stick to OxCal itself. The other benefit, if we use OxCal, within OxCal, we can do sequential calibration, which is currently not available in R itself. So if you want to do that kind of analysis, you have currently to use an external tool that might be OxCal. And here, OxCal comes in handy. So the idea is OxCal is able to calibrate, simulate, and sum C14 dates using OxCal as calibration engine. And if we do that, we have firstly set up OxCal to get OxCal itself on your computer. We don't do that online. We download OxCal, put it in a temporary folder, and then you can run OxCal on your computer. You don't have to download it yourself. This little line of code does that for you, install everything, put the references in the right place, and then you can go with calibrating the date, and this is what you get out. Here is what type of date you have, some name, BP, standard deviation, and then here the unmodeled sigma ranges. But that's not all. I mean, unmodeled sigma ranges, you want probably to do more stuff with that. This is the content with the structure command of one calibrated date. You can see here we have some metadata, the name, what type it is,
the calibration curve with all the calibration curve values and the sigma ranges, but you can also access the raw probabilities of the calibration result with the dates and the according probabilities. If you do a sequential calibration, you also have the posterior information here, the posterior sigma ranges and also the posterior probabilities. This is a simple calibration, no sequential calibrations going on here, so these are an A in that case. So if you want to access the raw probabilities from the calibration result, that's fairly easy. You have to just question, let's get back. You see it's a list. Every C14 date here is one item in the list of the result. You can calibrate multiple dates at once. If you have this result, then you can access the first date, let's say, and then the raw probabilities from them, the dates and the probabilities, and make a very standard plot of the result of the C14 date. It doesn't look very nice, so we implemented a costume plot function. And you can see here the sigma ranges graphically, the shape of the calibrated result, very much like you would probably expect the result from Oscar. You can also plot multiple dates. So if you here have multiple dates, insert as a vector and then plot that, you get the plot of the different dates in their temporal relationship. And you can also plot that on the calibration curve, because sometimes, of course, it might be interesting to see what causes the wiggles in your calibrated date. This plot will improve in the next release, but still it's already usable and helpful, I think. And what goes beyond the calibration is simulation. We utilize the simulation function from Oxcal and call that directly. So if we want to simulate a date, see that's BC and the minus stands for BC then, 3400 cal BC, we give it an uncertainty that we would like our simulated C14 dates to have. And then it's the back calibration, you get the calibrated result back again. And that comes in handy if you want to do some simulations, which is very necessary if you want to have an educated C14 calibration for complicated structures. You can do that even further. We have also a function that do some simulation of some calibration. So we give it a BC begin and a BC end, the number of dates that we would like to have, some standard deviations. You could put in also here a vector of different standard deviations for each and every individual date. And then you can define what the distribution of the dates should be, either uniform, so uniform random distribution, or equidistant distribution, so that every date has the same distance on the temporal axis from each other. And then we can plot that, and you see here is the result of the sum. And you can also plug in arbitrary R code. For example, there are some R functions that produces Oxcal code. And if you can script that, in this case, it would probably have been easier if I would have written the original Oxcal code. But you can, if you have a large database, for example, like the C14 Bazaar, you can script that for your dates and then get proper Oxcal code out, plug that into Oxcal itself, and then get a result out. You can see here boundary, prior and posterior dates, boundary in between, prior and posterior distributions, and then the end product. So all of the functionality of Oxcal is now available within the R framework, which we hope you might utilize and it might be helpful for your own investigations. And we would love to get feedback from you if you try that out and find some errors. Of course, there are still some in there. The C14 Bazaar is currently ready for takeoff. So we had a workshop at the beginning of the conference where we tried that out and already find some ideas for improvements. And I will communicate that to you later on. But if we have installed that, we can go to CRAN. Oxcal is already on CRAN. The first release has been done, but the Bayesian calibration is currently only available on GitHub, and the same applies here. Within this month, we would like to finish Oxcal second version or 1.1, and then we release that also on CRAN. So this is based on the work of a lot of other people and has kind of a history already, and we still develop that together with the ISAC group further. Here are our contacts. You can find the presentation at Clemens GitHub repository. You can find the Oxcar and C14 Bazaar tool at the Git, the ISAC GitHub repository. I hope you can use these tools. Thank you for your attention.